We're starting a new series. It's from Overcomers International Fellowship, a Dream Center of St. Cloud in Wilmer. And we're a nonprofit. We've been around for 22 years. And you're going to hear more about us and all of that type of thing. But we've had a dear friend over the years that has really helped our ministry and has been such a community resource and has helped everybody in this community. He's been on television for years and years. And Gary has come and said, you know, I want to get back on television. I want to start producing some shows. And so we wanted to help Gary in any way we possibly could, because he has helped all of us in this whole entire community. And most of you know him. Most of you have seen his show. If you've grown up in anywhere in central Minnesota, you've heard him, you've seen him, you've watched his information shows. So we're going to start this whole new series now. And we're really excited about it. My dear friend, Gary Zimmermann.
Well, amen. Amen, Pastor Michael.
So we're going to interview Gary. He's been interviewing everybody for years. Gary, where did you grow up?
I grew up in a small town over by Albany, Minnesota, which is St. Anthony, Minnesota, which is from Albany, 6 miles north, a very small town, very Catholic community town.
Good. So out in the country or right in town?
Right out in the country, where the calls go moo, and the dogs go woo. Anyway.
Gary, when did you first start, or your desire to get into television production?
Well, when I went down to Brown Institute, and they said I had a nasally sounding voice. So they said, you didn't get into the school, but you can try your cable company in the area, which is St. Cloud, which I did. I went over to, at the time, it was TCI. Anyway, one of the cable systems in St. Cloud got me started, and the rest is history. I used to, when I was doing it, I used to call it a variety show, but one of the Metro bus drivers said, you know, if you're going to be a talk show, you're going to be educational. Why don't you call it the Gary Zimmermann Show? Well, that's what I started out with many years ago.
How many years ago?
About over, since 1993, over 20-some years I've been doing it. So what I did is, so I took the bus driver's advice, and I called the Gary Zimmermann Show, and I brought educational stuff out there. And some people, parents have said, you know, you are a very clean talk show. You're not dirty. You don't say unfit words. You keep it to God's message. And that's what I've done through the years as the Gary Zimmermann Show has progressed. But then I decided later in the broadcasting life to short set the Gary Zimmermann Show. Hey, why don't you call it the Gary Z Show? And that's what I have done it as the Gary Z Show, right here in St. Cloud, and even on YouTube.com. So that's Gary Z Show.
Wonderful. So how many shows did you produce over all of those years? Several hundred, I'm sure, huh?
I would say about 700.
Yeah, wonderful.
Yes, and I enjoy what I do. If I can bring an educational show out there, that's all that matters to me. That's the work of God.
Let's go to the bloopers. What was one of your worst memories that happened on television that you did, or interviews? I want to do one of the worst and then some of the best and some of the in between.
One of the worst shows where I had a guest who did real short, like one word answers. You know, as a producer, that makes life very hard to do, but you got to overcome that. And the rest is history. And then the shows that I've done with people in the radio business here in the St. Cloud area, and even the legend of KVSC, even the legend of Elvis Presley. So I do a montage of wonderful stuff. So again, the worst memory is when a person did one answer, you know, yes, no, maybe. Boy, I tell you, as a broadcaster, that is the toughest time of life. But we did it.
Wonderful. What show really brought a tear to your eye? Do you remember any of those?
Well, that would be when you came to my studio.
I was that bad?
No, you weren't that bad.
Gary did it when we were first starting our homeless shelter stuff way back in the day. Would have been 96 or 97 or so, whenever. And Gary came and we were on his show. And Sandra, my wife, and he's always been promoting, helping people with disabilities, mm-hmm. And we actually even had you come to our church and mm-hmm. speak about mm-hmm. your story and disabilities and people with disabilities and different things like that. But you've really had left a footprint in this community. And a couple years ago here, you kind of stopped producing mm-hmm. through for whatever reason, doesn't matter. And you basically poured out your heart and your life into these shows. You never took a penny. You never got your anything. This was public broadcasting. Mm-hmm. It was a total sacrifice of your time, mm-hmm. your effort, your heart. And you've always called it, you've always told me that it's part of what God has put on your heart mm-hmm. to bring forth interviews and education. And you've told so many different stories of the nonprofits and the different real champions in our community, whether they be an athlete, whether it be somebody from the Boy Scouts, the Girl Scouts, to the veterans and the veteran stand down programs, to the mm-hmm. Salvation Army. I mean, you've had everybody on. You've had the mayor on, right?
Yep, the mayors of the area have had them on too.
And to really bring a voice that, you know, and we have a community here that has really been informed by you. You've brought forth a message of hope, encouragement, and letting people make up their own minds about things. And really brought a great educational program that has taught all of us and reached this entire community. And we really honor you for that. And that's why we want to partner with you. And we want to see you go forward in this next season of your life. Mm-hmm. And we've known you all of these years. You've been such a dear friend to us. And so we're excited about this new season that we're going to see you produce some great shows. Mm-hmm. And we're just excited. And it's such a blessing for us to be involved with it. Mm-hmm. So let's take a break here. And we're going to come back and we're going to interview the great, legendary Gary Z. Okay, we're back to Overcomers International Fellowship, Dream Center TV, and we're seeing the historical first show with Gary Z, and we're interviewing this local celebrity, this man that has championed so many different causes, so many different, and educated all of us. Now, we've known you've been a television producer and all of that, but you've been involved with so many other things. You've done a lot of work with the different radio stations. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about how you got started over at St. Cloud State and the other places.
Well, if you want to go way back when, my hometown radio out of Albany, Minnesota, Chasm, that's where the bug really came in and said, you know, this is something I really wanted to do. And back in high school, my school teachers told me, you're never going to be able to do it. You're never going to be able to do it. But I proved her wrong. And she has told me that I proved her wrong. So that was how I did that. So, and then I moved to the St. Cloud area. And then I went to the radio stations here in St. Cloud, the nonprofit, KVSC. I've been over there. I'm even a big hockey fan. I even did something with the radio station KVSC, which is nonprofit, Gary's Corner, but that's no longer on the voice of the radio station. So yeah, that's what I've done. Also, something I want to mention too, one of my first shows that I did when I got started as the Gary Zimmermann Show was cerebral palsy. You know, people out there with cerebral palsy have a struggle in life too. And if they have a struggle, I want to make it better for them so that they can have a normal life. Because when I was in school, people would used to make fun of me, pick on me, you know, I'd be last, but I've overcome that, and the rest is history. So cerebral palsy is the pride of my show, first show of the Gary Zimmermann Show, back in 1993, Pastor Michael Laidlaw.
Wonderful. You've been involved with, and one of the other big things that you do is the community announcements, mm-hmm. and you go around to all of the nonprofits, you take the bus, you transport yourself around, mm-hmm. and you go to the different nonprofits to promote whatever events that they're going on. And you have a regular route every month here, and you've been doing this.
So?
How many years have you been doing that?
I've lost count.
But he will come faithfully once a month. He'll call me. I'm coming over. What do you got for community events? And how many other nonprofits do you work with and with that?
A lot. I'd say maybe 10 for a rough number.
Isn't that tremendous that somebody would really hold us accountable to help us promote? I always say, well, Gary holds me accountable because
he does.
He comes and he says, okay, what do you got for events and what can we promote this month and what's coming up next month and what other events are going on in the community? So that, you know, the community billboard is just what it is. It announces all of these wonderful events that are happening by all of the different nonprofits and the special programming that's coming up, and where people and families and people that are struggling or whatever can reach out to those different nonprofits. And that segment of what you do for a ministry is just wonderful. And it you know, I can just think of all of the people, you know, scanning through the channels, and they come to the community bulletin board and they'll stop. And you're responsible for over half of those, I'm sure, that are on there.
You think so?
I'm sure you are.
Okay. But I want to make note, I don't get paid for what I do. It's all volunteer. I want to help the people out there. So I want to clarify that for the record, Pastor Michael.
Well, of course. And just doing that sacrificial service that, and just pouring out your heart to this community. It's such a ministry of just letting people know what's going on. People are hurting, people are struggling, or people want to go to a family-oriented event, or they want to go to a church service, or they want to go to a support group or something, and here it is on that community billboard. So, you know, most everybody knows you as the TV guy.
Oh, yeah.
But you do so many, you know, you're over there at St. Cloud State on the radio station there.
I used to be.
Well, you've had an impact over there. And you're doing, you know, you do the community announcements, which is just huge, and promoting all of the different events and services that are going on in the community. And, you know, that's a piece that nobody knows about you. And we want to expose the truth of this champion in our community out there doing what he's just sacrificing his time and effort to go forward and making our community a better place to live in. And we just so appreciate you, Gary. And we'll be right back after this. Welcome back to Overcomers International Fellowship TV. We're interviewing one of the first shows here, Gary's new season of television shows, and we're putting him on the spot. We're interviewing him. We're getting it, digging into all of the depths of what he has done for the community. And we just in this last segment, we were talking about the community bulletin board. But you go beyond just posting it on the community bulletin board. You leave here, I know, every time with a whole handful of posters and flyers to hang up all over the community, to put them up on all of the other community billboards. And what an impact that is, and sacrifice. You know, you could be going out and doing all sorts of other things.
Yeah.
And, or for career, or money, or whatever else. And here you're just such a blessing to this entire community. I want to, we want to talk a little bit about some of the future shows, but, you know, you bring up your faith a lot of times and you feel that this is a ministry. How much is your faith involved in your daily life and in your routine? And is it the whole kind of the foundation stone of why you do what you do and who you are?
Yes. My Catholic faith is very important to me, to what I do for God, because God is the reason why I do what I do, because I truly love that. I truly want to help the people in the St. Cloud area, because, you know, everyone has a story to tell in their daily life, and that's what I do in my life, so that people out there can know that, yes, there's something out there that you can do. There is a nonprofit out there that you can make it go forth.
You know, in all of our, you know, in all of our faiths, we are supposed to serve our community, serve our humanity. And no one has done a better example of that than living out your faith on a daily basis of helping and serving and caring for our community, mm-hmm. and making an impact and getting the word out, getting some positive message out, some event out, some story out there that has touched somebody, that has really made a difference in somebody's life. And now you're coming into a new season,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to be producing, helping you, partnering with you here to see these programs go forward. So what's on your heart as far as in this season of still going to keep the same format of interviewing and yeah. and things like that? And where do you want to go with this? What do you envision yourself doing here?
Well, we're going to call this new show that we're going to be doing with Pastor Mike, and we're just going to go through the community of St. Cloud and stop by and talk to different nonprofits and get the word out there. Maybe we might go to the jailhouse and talk to the police chief or the Stearns County people and get the insight, or county commissioners, the attorneys, the mayors. So wherever I take it, along with Mike Thompson, who's our video person, and we're just going to go out and bring this ministry to the people so that the people can make their daily lives go forth in their daily life too. There we go, folks.
Wonderful, wonderful. I'm very excited about it.
Thank
and
you.
I've got some ideas. I want to take do a video of a or do a show of somebody that's just coming out of let's say they've spent their time at a shelter,
mm-hmm.
and now transitioning out into the community, and how difficult that is, and what the steps that they have to do to come out of homelessness into being self-supportive is a huge, huge journey for them.
Mm-hmm.
Their lifestyles, taking care of their addictions or their compulsions or their behavior issues or their mental health issues, mm-hmm. and really see that whole transition as somebody goes through those. And I think we can do a good job with
mm-hmm.
that
mm-hmm.
with video. I also want to partner with you if, as somebody just comes out of prison with their blue coat and their orange hat, and they come out, and all, and we're going to take them, we're going to do a show just on all of the different steps and the things that they have to go through from getting out that day to transitioning into their aftercare programs, their treatment programs, the accountability that they have to live under probation and all of those types of things, and into the workforce and into work readiness programs and right into transitioning into mm-hmm. maybe a part-time job or a full-time job, and then transition them right out back into the community to be a tax-paying, productive person, and to see that transformation that God's hand has been in this from the day they got out. In fact, the day they went in to that system, and because somebody had to take them off the street and out of their own behaviors in a place of safety, in a place of incarceration, and then on the way, all that whole journey. So I want to see us do that and produce that
mm-hmm.
Program too, and so many other ones too, because I think that people have a lot of compassion, but and we see somebody with a sign and, you know, give to the homeless, or I'm, you know, anything helps. You know, we see those signs around
mm-hmm.
St. Cloud. And there's a lot of services out there. And some people choose to do that. But they don't have to. There are help. There are services out there. We have a continual, with the nonprofits that we have in this region, in this area, the needs are being met.
Mm-hmm.
And I think there's a lot of fear and mm-hmm. misinformation out there about people and different things like that. And we want to really tell their story
mm-hmm.
in a way that is going to be informative and factual and get rid of some of the fear and some
stereotypes.
Of the stigmatism that's out there about people. And I think you've been very good about that. Mm-hmm. With, you know, your whole life has been about exposing the different problems or people with different issues or different types of disabilities, whether they have a learning disability, they have cerebral palsy, they've mm-hmm. got mental illness, they've got chemical dependency, and really to go after some of those stigmas that are out there about people, to see that, yes, they have a disability, mm-hmm. but they have abilities. Mm-hmm. And we have so many wonderful resources in this community that I think we can tell a lot of stories mm-hmm. and inform a lot of people that want to know the real factual stories about their lives and what God can do in their lives, and to network with all of the other program and services, medical services, mental health services, chemical dependency services, and work with all of the other work readiness programs and everything else to see their lives.
And also, too, that I'm interested when you mention that, too, Pastor Michael, when people get out of the jail systems here in this area, how that's going to change my life and into their life. So that's another opportunity I'm looking for that Pastor Michael is going to help us out with, too, because he has some great resources. Right, Pastor?
Thank you, Gary. Mm-hmm. It's been a real blessing. And we're looking for some great, great programming coming up here. And we had to interview you first because you're the man.
You're the guy. You're God's work.
No, I'm just his servant, and so are you.
Yeah.
And we're going to really try to produce some great programs for you. If you want to contact us to volunteer or to be a part of serving others, we've been here for many, many years at OIF Dream Center. And that's 529 16th Avenue North, St. Cloud, Minnesota. And our Facebook is OIF Dream Center of St. Cloud. Our website is dreamcenterofstcloud.org. And please be involved and be a part of the solution for people's issues. And join us. Thank you very much.
Sitting on the throne with my Jesus.